fingers on the note.
If it wasn't for the pharmacies not verifying anything, none of this would work.
According to state police, with no database recording narcotic prescriptions, scammers can fake injuries with multiple doctors and then fill copied prescriptions like these at different stores. Listen to one recent case of a woman released from prison.
And in the course of being out in just 2 months, she went to see 48 different doctors and got 48 different prescriptions and filled them at 48 different pharmacies.
The question is, how do you stop it? Some say a drug monitoring program, a state database that tracks who is getting powerful pills. 34 states have them. New Hampshire is the only New England state that doesn't. The idea has failed in Concord before, mainly for privacy concerns. Representative Cindy Rosenwald argues the most recent proposal would not be a police tool, but a health tool. People caught filling multiple prescriptions wouldn't get a visit from police, but rather a letter sent to their doctor.
They could know that their patient had been dispensed a number of controlled substances from various physicians, various pharmacies, and it might be a good idea for them to have a talk with their patient.
But some, like Bedford pharmacist Ron Petrin, say he's seen little evidence the programs work. Either way, he says, it would need to be real time. Otherwise, crooks could fill multiple orders and be long gone before they're red flagged.
So by the time all the information gets put wherever it's going to be put, stored and analyzed by whomever, you change name, you change ID. So I don't know how valuable that's going to be.
The current proposal doesn't specify if it's real time or not. He also says pharmacies already police fraudsters, making sure ID is required, calling other pharmacies about potential con artists or stolen prescription pads. And they also look for obvious red flags.
If this is the first time you've walked in and you're getting OxyContin, why are you coming here? Who's your doctor? I mean, those flags go up.
We checked with the major chains. Walgreens didn't want to comment for the story. Both CVS and Rite Aid wouldn't talk about how prescriptions are verified, but did say they have policies in place to help detect and prevent fraudulent activity, and that all licensed pharmacists have a responsibility to use their professional judgment before dispensing a prescription. According to Marco, dealers are still fooling the system, and he is leaking the dirty secrets, hoping to make amends and make a change.
They have to start paying attention, because if it wasn't for the pharmacies and for the doctors, none of this would be possible.
The bill to create a statewide drug monitoring program has been tabled until next year. As for Marco, he says he plans on contacting local pharmacies with detailed information on how con artists and addicts scam the system. I'm Sean McDonald, WMUR News 9.